I now invite Ms. Leilani Rania Ganser of Reed College to take a seat at the petitioner's table. You have the floor, madam.
Hafaday, Gwahusi Leilani Rania Ganser. I'm a student of colonial violence, a survivor of sexual and domestic abuse, and a native Chamorro woman. The fact that I am a Chamorro woman and a victim of intimate partner violence influences my work in anti-colonization. After all, the man who attacked me was a white United States citizen. War and sexual violence are the twin pillars of dominance in dispossessed nations. American anthropologist Catherine Lutz describes my home by saying, Guam objectively has the highest ratio of US military spending and military hardware and land takings from indigenous populations of any place on Earth. This means that the Chamorro people live in a simulated war zone. With a recent UN Women report stating that it is often more dangerous to be a woman than a soldier in modern conflict zones, this suggests that the impact on Chamorro women is specifically severe. Sexual violence is a tactic of war used to terrorize civilian populations, and this context cannot be separated from the current political status of the island and the day-to-day lives of the indigenous population living there. We saw the rampant sexual assault around the U.S. military base in Okinawa, and now fear that the transfer of troops from Okinawa to Guam will bring the same violence to our home. Gendered violence against Chamorro women cannot be separated from the racism and colonialism pervasive in American society. So solutions and responses to gendered violence on Guam must also address anti-colonialism, especially in the case of state-sponsored violence. My grandmother, Brigida Rania, is a survivor of the Japanese occupation of Guam. There were stories of repeated rapes, of women being gathered into caves and beheaded after their assaults. Studies of survivors of the Holocaust show that descendants of those interned tend to produce lower levels of the stress-regulating hormone cortisol. This means that they are uniquely predisposed to develop post-traumatic stress disorder like I did after my abuse. And all of this trauma exists on a backdrop of continued abuse. Guam has the second highest rate of sexual assault in its administrative country. The only area that surpasses our rate of sexual assault is Alaska, where indigenous women also face the brunt of the violence. And yet the logic of colonialism and sexual assault continues to provide the structure for American policies regarding the indigenous peoples living inside its claimed borders. While Chamorros are considered an alien race in the United States, the administering power still feels comfortable in claiming ownership over our land and our people, our bodies and livelihoods themselves. And this is what my rapist did to me. He did not see me as worthy of humanity. He just wanted to express ownership over me. And ownership in this fashion flies directly in the face of the egalitarian and matriarchal values taught to Chamorros from an early age. It is antithetical to the universal right for self-determination. Respect for Chamorro women individually must begin internationally. As a daughter of Fu'una, a daughter of Guahan, I ask that you ensure a safe future for my little sister, Kale'ana. I ask that you work more actively with the Chamorro people to decolonize our islands and our bodies so she may see in her lifetime what self-determination looks like. And a key step in this, a mandatory step in this, is securing a UN visiting mission to our country so you may see firsthand what the extremes of this dispossession look like. Sainamasi.